Hi everyone, in this video we discuss text parsing and text filter nodes in SAS Enterprise Miner. The text parsing node allows us to parse a document collection in order to quantify information about the terms that are contained therein. You can use the text parsing node with volumes of textual data such as email messages, news, articles, web pages, research papers, and surveys. To add a text parsing node, on the text mining tab, drag the text parsing node into the diagram workspace and connect it to the data source node. On the properties panel, we can use default settings by SAS Enterprise Miner, or we can change the settings to tell SAS Enterprise Miner how to parse the text. To do so, we need to focus on selections for detect group, ignore group, and synonyms group. For example, we can process multi-word groups as single terms, identify each term's part of speech based on its context, extract entities such as addresses, date, phone numbers, and company names. We can also choose to ignore all terms that are a particular part of speech, use a stop list to ignore a specific set of terms, or use a start list to restrict parsing to only a specific set of terms. Additionally, we can return the root forms of terms and treat all terms that have the same stem as equivalent, or specify synonyms and treat them as equivalent. The details of properties of the text parsing node can be found in SAS TextMiner reference help. In this example, we use the default properties by SAS Enterprise Miner. Right-click at text parsing, select Run, and click Yes to run the node. The run is completed. Select Results. These are results of text parsing. In the upper left corner, we see the ZIPF plot, which displays a scatter plot of the number of documents for each term, where each is sorted and plotted by rank. The horizontal axis of the plot shows the terms by their rank, and the vertical axis shows the number of documents in which the term appears. If you position the mouse pointer over a point, then the tooltip indicates the term name, rank, and number of documents. For example, we see the term wide has a rank of 1919, and there are 6 documents in which this term appears. One of the top ranked term, that, which has the 10th ranking and 73 documents, use this term. Of course, we can see that many terms might not be applicable or meaningful, and later we need to use text filter to filter these terms. The terms window shows us the terms and frequencies. We can see B is the most frequent term. This is a verb, and SAS Enterprise Miner uses all different versions of this verb and group them in the same category. SAS Enterprise Miner also decides not to keep this term based on the default settings we use. So the common verbs, adverbs, or nouns such as be, have, not, other will be excluded. Nouns such as government, state, power will be used. Again, you can develop your own start list, stop list, and synonyms to identify meaningful terms. We have other plots. The number of documents by frequency scatter plot displays the number of documents in which a term appears versus the frequency of occurrence of that term in the entire document collection. The row by frequency bar chart displays the total frequency of occurrence past terms in the document collection, broken down by term row. The attribute by frequency bar chart displays the total frequency of occurrence of past terms in the document collection, broken down by attributes. So that was the text parsing process. The next step is text filtering. The text filter node can be used to reduce the total number of past terms or documents that are analyzed. Therefore, you can eliminate extraneous information so that only the most valuable and relevant information is considered. For example, the text filter node can be used to remove unwanted terms, and to keep only documents that discuss a particular issue. This reduced data set can be orders of magnitude smaller than the one that represents the original collection, which might contain hundreds of thousands of documents and hundreds of thousands of distinct terms. To add a text filter node on Text Mining tab, drag the text filter node into the diagram workspace and connect it to the text parsing node. On the Properties panel, we will make some changes. We will focus on weightings properties. The term weighting options in the text filter node allows us to vary the importance of terms based on how frequently the terms occur in individual documents and how terms are distributed throughout the document collection. First, the frequency weighting methods include frequency weighting functions such as binary or log. In this example, we change it to none. Second, the term weighting methods are useful for distinguishing important terms from others. Such enterprise miner uses different term weighting methods such as entropy, inverse document frequency, and mutual information. You can find the details of these methods in SAS and Text Miner reference help. In this example, we use the inverse document frequency method. Basically, this method gives greater weight to the terms that occur infrequently in the document collection. Since the term frequency tends to incorrectly emphasize documents using the more frequent terms without giving enough weight to the more meaningful terms, this method diminishes the weight of terms that occur very frequently in the documents and increases the weight of terms that occur rarely. Right-click at text filter, select Run, and click Yes. The run is completed. Let's see the results. First, we'll look at the ZIPF plot again. We can see some changes in the plot. If we move the mouse over the chart at the top ranked terms, we see more meaningful terms in this top list, such as people, convention, department, etc. Next, let's look at the terms table. We can see that government is the most frequent term and has a weight of 1. The status of this term is keep. The verb have is the second most frequent term but has a weight of 0 and will be dropped. In this list, we can see the terms, role, weights, status, and rank. It is important to examine this list carefully and see which terms are kept and which terms are dropped from the further analysis. That is how to use text parsing and text filter nodes. Thank you, and bye now.